Good evening all. Okay, so ours is the last but not the least presentation which we are going to talk about here. My name is Chandrakant Dhutadmal, and I work with CDAC, Center for Development of Advanced Computing, which is a government organization in Government of India. And I have my friend Mr. Rajesh Ranjan, who is open source community manager with NEGD, which is also associated with the Government of India for its e-governance project.
I just joined there in Government of India 3 months back as open source community manager and based at Delhi. I was earlier in Pune with Red Hat. I worked for Red Hat 10 years and I learned a lot from Red Hat how to work with the open source. Before that I was in community. But after working with 1-2 years, I joined in Red Hat, and this is how. And I started OpenOffice translation 10 years back for Hindi language, and I become after 1-2 years, I become a marketing lead for OpenOffice in India, and after that, LibreOffice started. Then again, I am translating here for Hindi.
So what we're going to talk about is how is the community, LibreOffice community in India. As you know, I mean, let me tell you that Rajesh Ranjan is the one who brought me into this community stuff.
That is okay.
So yeah, to be very honest, the community in India, LibreOffice community in India is not so huge, is a very small community. And if you talk about the community, it's mostly from localization team. So when we you know analyzed the community in India, we thought it's very small and we need to grow that up. So unlike other presentations, what we will be talking about here is how we can grow this community, so-called LibreOffice community. And that is where this particular idea came up when we were discussing that, this is a good time when we come together and start discussing about what is the problem, why there is no big community in India. And the first of its kind, the meeting on LibreOffice community took place way back in May 14. And this is the meeting which we did in Red Hat office.
Yes, actually we are discussing about LibreOffice things, and I was earlier in marketing lead for India for OpenOffice, so I was thinking that, but there were a lot of different type of burden with us, but we planned that better we should start with something. So we asked with different localizer, because major localization community was there. So we asked all the persons, and we took a place in the Red office in a conference room, and we asked all the person to come there, and we arranged some pizza and whatever there for all the persons, and we did some brainstorming there, ideation there, and
we
after that something
reports.
Happened.
Yeah. So as Italo says, what we should be targeting about is not the ones who are already using, or not those people who are already onto Linux systems. What we should be targeting is those who are on, other platforms like Microsoft Windows, for example, where people would not have heard about, LibreOffice and its importance and why they should migrate to LibreOffice. So when I said it's a small community, it was in that particular terms that, you won't find many people on Windows who are using LibreOffice there. So that's what this particular idea started out.
So these are all the list of persons who are localizer in Hindi languages. We have 22 who don't know. For their information, we have 22 official languages. Apart from that, lot of languages are there. But at least we should count for our sake, for our easiness, 22 languages. And here we have, and we are trying to do some more languages and for CDAC.
Okay. Right. So there is a program called the TDIL, Technology Development for Indian Languages Program of Government of India. What it tries to do is it tries to combine all the free and open source softwares into one disk, and along with that softwares, they also try to pitch in some basic tools, like, you know, how do you type in Indian languages, because typing in Indian languages itself is a major problem, unlike others other languages, because the other languages, most of the times, they use the standard keyboard which is available on the computer, but in case of Indian languages, for those who know, it is difficult. So you cannot use the same keyboard which you see or which you find it everywhere. So what we have to do is we have to have a special layout, a special keyboard layout, wherein all the different Indian language characters are placed. So to tell you, even if even that the typing problem in all the Indian languages is still not available for all the people. So what government is trying to do is trying to bring all this basic and elementary stuff, you know, in one CD, and then distribute to the common people, so that the usage of the language is increased. And more importantly, as it is said, we have included this LibreOffice, localized versions of LibreOffice in that CD, and that is distributed.
Lars Norbo bedes henvende sig til receptionen, og det var Lars Norbo.
Oh, I got afraid. Okay, so recently there was a conference in Bhopal, which was a World Hindi Literature Conference, wherein Government of India had distributed approximately 25,000 such discs to common people. And we'll show you that thing. So the major component of the community in India is localization, and that's how it is.
Most of the localizers are seasoned here. We are having Krishna Babu here. Is also from Tamil. We are having here persons, and any Peter who given presentation for Janatas, he is doing for Malayalam. We are having 4-5 persons here in this list. This is about digital India. Actually, what for the community perspective, I wanted to tell you in front of you that this can be the biggest opportunity for us, because the new government is very much serious about making it penetrate inside even a village. So almost 250,000 villages, panchayat we are calling it, is a group of villages, their common service center is going to be established within 3 years, and it's already in plan. And 150,000 post office is going to be multi-service center. So everywhere will be computer, and everywhere and the people, that's the lowest strata, people in the lowest strata can have reach to the computer. So this Digital India is the biggest Government of India plan announced this year, and they have very big agenda for this thing.
So they have also a plan of, you know, making at least one person from each household a digitally literate person. So we could take this advantage and try to promote and proliferate LibreOffice in India. Okay, so this is all about the open source policy which Government of India has recently released. So what it talks about is the Government of India projects and initiatives, whatever are there, should try and use open source softwares. So this is where we can take a leverage upon. And as it is, you know, in other countries also, it is not yet a compulsory thing, or it's a mandatory thing, but the government is trying to make that mandatory and see that, you know, lot of the initiatives make use of such free and open source softwares.
Yes, if you can see this document now, it's so much open source friendly. The second one link is 115 times. If you search for open source word phrase, you can find open source word 115 times. So such a positive policy towards open source is there, and in this thing LibreOffice is placed as a standard and preferential tool for that documentation and other purposes, other related purposes. So you can find the name LibreOffice, you can search the LibreOffice things there itself.
Now this is something called as Bharat Operating System Solutions. Now this is the variant of Linux system which has been indigenously developed in India, and government of India is trying to put this particular operating system in almost all the government organizations. So anyway, by default, this BOS operating system, which is an operating system in itself, will have LibreOffice.
It's already having.
It is already having.
So slowly, this is going to penetrate inside the offices of Government of India.
Yep.
Certainly, the LibreOffice is going to penetrate everywhere.
So why we are mentioning it here is because once this operating system is installed in major government segments or domains or offices, this is going to increase the usage of LibreOffice.
This is about a fuel project. Actually, we tried to build a community around languages and linguistic resources. 10 years before, when I joined Red Hat, then I was very much frustrated with consistency and standardization in translation. When I was translating save as or print preview, so somebody were telling that why you are translate like this, you should translate like this. So I thought that this is a good idea. Better I should put you all at one place and ask your suggestion, finally release that suggestion, and we call it fuel, frequently used entries for localization. We collected some of the term from desktop application. LibreOffice, OpenOffice was at that time, 7 years back, and we collected all the entries of 3-4 level from different most popular applications of Linux applications, and we called it frequently used entries for localization. So around this glossary initiative, we have created a repository of not only glossary, linguistic resources of open source linguistic resources. You can tell it a largest open source linguistic resources because it covers in almost 60 languages, and it is having a style guide, it is having translation assessment matrix, it is having glossary, evaluated glossary, it is a domain based glossary like fuel for desktop, fuel for mobile, fuel for web, fuel for cloud, fuel for, we are going beside IT also, fuel for agriculture, fuel for health. So for the whole translation localization domain, we are creating a thing, and this become a Government of India standard also. It is supported by Red Hat, Mozilla, Wikimedia,
CIDAC.
Government of India, CIDAC, Government of Maharashtra, several state government, and all language community.
So we can take help of this particular community to grow LibreOffice community as well. So
yes, that is most important. You can see these are two pictures.
So in year 2013 and 14, I mean last two consecutive years, we have been arranging a conference in India, wherein we call this language or localization professionals, and we discuss about various aspects of how we can take it ahead, or you know, their experiences and so on and so forth. This year also,
and this time we are going to do on 20th November. So Mozilla and different organization is sponsoring that one. So you are invited.
Yeah. Okay. So what about the organizations which are already on to LibreOffice, or who are already using LibreOffice at their places? So these are different organizations which I said is TDIL, Technology for Development of Indian Languages. We've got Synergy, we've got CDAC, we've got Kerala State IT Mission, Government of Maharashtra, STC, Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai, and so many others.
There are few names here, few major.
These
name,
are few
no.
Major names.
We can take support of these organizations also, again for our purpose, for our community purpose, community building, awareness and everything. So we have put their
yes.
name here.
Now, as far as the educational thing is concerned, Now, there are few initiatives which have been taken place. So, one of the initiatives is from CDAC, which talks about a certificate course in you know, open source softwares. Now, earlier it was Bharatiya Open Office, it's been localized open office, but now the because the page has not been changed, you know, it is still remains in open office. But the courses now which are being run are in LibreOffice, and we have got around 365 franchise centers across the country which has got this 1 month course on LibreOffice. So the proliferation itself on LibreOffice you know, education is good enough, and we can leverage upon this network to promote this. Another initiative is from IIT Mumbai, which is called as a spoken tutorial. So what it has done is it has created video tutorials on various open source softwares, including LibreOffice. So you can see this LibreOffice writer
in different languages also.
Yeah, and more importantly, this is available in multiple languages. So what you hear is in multiple languages, so that you know more audience is actually covered in
see,
that.
See, you can see that LibreOffice writer on Boss Linux. So that same Boss, na, Bharat operating system solution, na,
and this is
in Marathi. See that how much. How much module is there in Marathi? 462 different
modules are there.
Modules are there.
Okay, so these are some of the promotional activities. As I said, so we participated in 10th Vishwa Hindi Sammelan, that's World Hindi Conference, which was in Bhopal, and then we also participated in Marathi Sahitya Sammelan, again World Marathi Literature Conference, which was held in Port Blair, Andaman. And then there are other, you know, such initiatives where we went to some engineering colleges, and then some tech shows were there, some of the other organizations like Krishi Vidyan Kendra, which is an agricultural institute, and then this, some of the schools, so which we, Wisdom World School, and so many other places. So, the presentation is all about, is talking all about what is currently there in India, and how we can try to build this community to a larger community.
Somehow related to LibreOffice.
Yes.
On the basis of that thing, how we can build a vibrant and a good supporting community who can favor LibreOffice especially.
Yeah. And now, this being the first conference for us, we have got to learn from
a lot
of people, especially Italo. We are very much thankful to you. You have given very good insights into this. And of course, Kaur and, you know, others, and this gave us, you know, real good motivation to work
to understand
even
the
better
flow of actually every community has open source community has one mindset, but every open source different open source community has different type of mindset also, some different culture also, some type of difference is there. So we understand a lot here.
So, of course, these things, community building or brand awareness, training and migration, supporting other Indian languages, and, you know, bringing more organization on board is all what we plan to do in coming days. So,
and different bullet marks can come.
So, this is the communication things. I mean, we have a mailing list specific to India. It was created last year. And then we have also have a Facebook page. Of course,
just
it was
created.
Just created. I mean, yesterday it was created when we heard about, you know, other community pages. So
going on Facebook and Google Plus.
Next year you will see number of people which are here. So that's it from our side. Thank you so much, and we are
question.
Happy to take any quick questions if we have. Maybe they are basic, but we'll try to answer. Yes.
I have one question. You said that you have 22 languages,
yes.
Dialects in India that you localize, them, right?
Yeah.
And did you meet any problem showing different words? I mean, those dialects should maybe have different text, different characters.
Yes.
And
yes.
You must use different fonts.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you have any difficulty showing or dealing with those? Different encoding or different fonts.
Yes. So yeah, I'll answer to his question. I understand what you are trying to tell, because India has got so many languages, and once we are trying to bring all those languages on board LibreOffice, there are going to be problems, especially in terms of fonts, because not I mean, if you see in open source community, there are some languages for which you won't find, you know, free and open source fonts which are Unicode compatible. Okay, so the problem is, we are going to face that problem. We need to have such fonts which are there in open source and which supports those languages. So when you see this particular slide, first, second slide, we said that not all of them are here. Now these are the languages or 13 languages which are currently there with LibreOffice, and these languages don't have any problems. The ones which we are trying to bring on board, you know, especially like Santali, Bodo, Dogri,
a smaller language, but not a smaller in the sense it's of
it's going to be a problematic situation.
With context to India, it's smaller language, but it's, they are also most of them are having population 1,000 million.
Yeah,
or
maybe
10 million at least. Huh?
Yeah.
You know that for the localization, it's better that you talk with Sophie and Christian.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
To
yeah.
have an instance on Poodle and create all the strings.
Yes, we know
right.
the process. Yeah, we know.
We already started for some other languages.
Some of the languages are already there, but it's important that for each language, we get also a contact name, and because we have to get better organized
mm-hmm.
on that area.
Yes,
sure, sure.
We will do that.
We are trying. For that one, and
I understand that. I mean, 22 languages enough.
It's a very complex structure for us
also,
and
three more than the maximum. But 22 is crazy.
Making a balance between the all community member. Actually, unfortunately, we have most of them are our friend, and we work together since long, because of localization related
sure.
thing. But it is very much difficult to have a similar wavelength. And it's a chance of conflict. A lot of things is there. You can understand the diversity of India.
But you have, let's say, a reference language for everyone, like Hindi, or really there are areas of the country where there are different languages and people do not understand each other.
So there are some languages which are, you know, at least understood by most of the people. For example, Hindi is one language which is used or can be understood by most of them, not entire
not,
population.
Not entire.
Yeah,
yeah,
people are 1 billion. I mean, it's
yeah.
know, it's
so and English, of course, is can be.
But it's not
understood.
Native.
It's not native.
It's
not
native.
Native.
It's not coming under the 22 language, but
yeah,
it's a dominant language. It's,
yeah,
I
know.
A lot of people.
We should think about native communities. You know.
Yes.
English is okay. We all speak English, but. Is not our language, so
yes.
respect the native communities.
Right. So any
and just a question, if you are able to understand, it's just out of curiosity. In how many languages is Microsoft Office available?
That is also
not
8-9 language only. That is not much.
Even that
8 or 9 languages they are
okay.
they are available.
This
we
is,
have far more
a,
than that.
This is a winning point for LibreOffice. Remember
yes.
that.
Yes.
We will certainly make it in all 22 languages.
Definitely.
And it can be a very much big win. You already told that it can be a big win for us that we can say proudly that it's available in 22 languages.
As I said, CDAC, Government of India, and the community is going to try very hard to bring all these languages on board. That's it. That's what I can say.
But I think is a let's say it's a winning point, not only because we provide 22 against 9, but because providing 22, we show respect for each community.
Yes, that is very much important. That is very much important. It's not once we are writing on some mailing list, I also told that it's open source, not just for the just for money. If a single user is there and you want to contribute, open source is ready to take the contribution and respect their contribution. So that is the most important point. If a smaller language sees such a just 5% is also speaking and they are coming to you, so you won't tell that I won't take your contribution for the language. So this is the most important part of open source projects, I think.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, sorry.
There's a lot, the word open source, the term open source was more than 150 times in the document.
How about open standards? Is it also there? And how is it, what is the policy regarding using open standards, and in particularly, of course, the open document format?
Open document, already Government of India supported that.
That
one.
Is there in
already
the
supported that one.
This document
that,
policy.
That is present in that document.
Okay,
it's in
the document. And what does the document say about it?
See, unfortunately, there's no such... okay, so you're talking about what it says.
Yes.
Open document format, government already, much before, I think, it is already...
It is mentioned, but it's
no,
not
no.
yet very
no,
popular.
No, it's not popular, but it's Government of India supports that standard only, not Microsoft standard. It was a fight. I was not at that time in government. It was a fight when I was in Red Hat 2-3 years back, and finally Government of India was convinced that this is the format we should accept, and they accepted that thing. It is there, it is written in that document.
Yeah.
And opensource.com magazine also put a big article on that one, reviewing that policy. I sent that to the editor, and they wrote a very good article. You can search on the opensource.com.
No, I think the question is simple, yes or no. Is that ODX a national standard in India?
I think it is.
See. If you talk about,
could you please search on that? I think it is, because when we were the fight was going and a lot of articles were going,
the problem is, as it is with other countries also, it has been mentioned, but it's not yet mandatory yet.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean,
okay.
Government still accepts other file formats.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So.
And
yeah.
Are they, even if it's not mandatory? Are they putting resources to help people to start using it, or is it just on paper somewhere? Or is there actually people being paid to promote it?
We can write to you through mail, and we can just research on the thing.
Yeah,
because whatever I'm telling, I'm a little bit confused that what finally concluded.
Yeah.
But it was concluded in favor of open format. But
yeah,
I'm not sure.
So yeah,
better to.
There is a message on our mailing list that says something similar. Of course, the document is not in a language that I can understand. But it was maybe it was Danishka that sent the message. I don't remember. About the ODF in India. Were you or someone? I don't remember.
It's about the minutes. Of a meeting from state in India.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's the government of Maharashtra.
Yeah. It's in the marketing list, if I'm not wrong.
We have to create, we have to create a repository of the different documents and laws, because otherwise it's always on a memory of people,
yeah,
and we are becoming crazy.
So we need a nice map which we color.
Exactly.
Yes.
And the repository of the documents, even if they are in language that we don't understand, but 50 documents that say the same thing are impressive.
So how about if we have Wikipedia?
Exactly. I will work with Jos and with Mikhail to improve the website and provide. Not the PDF, but the ODF website to provide resources for people.
Krishna?
Thank you.
So when the community come on board, so we can see if the translation is there,
exactly.
And the ODF standard is implemented in the country. So if something is missing, so we can focus on the specific thing in that country. For example, in India, so these guys working hardly on localization. So if particular thing is missing, so we can focus on.
We can improve that.
Okay.
Yeah, for instance, there is a fantastic document done by the UK government has been published recently, that is really covering all the possible stuff, how you should create the document, how you should maintain the document, and which I think we should make popular, not just in that. We should create a document that we can share with people.
There's a strong contribution from the Netherlands.
Yeah. But if UK publishes that,
yeah.
The Netherlands publishes
so
that, France, it looks like is close to publishing something similar.
Yeah.
first. Then of course we go to the fourth state and say, three are already done it, doing it. What about you?
So this is, this gives the answer to your question. So, oh, Krishna.
Just there, it's on the internet.
Actually, everything is. I recently joined, but I, whatever I know, everything is inclined towards open standard, open source, everything.
We should be better in collecting these documents and making and sharing them.
And that document is also mentioned, what I referred in the slide now, that is mentioned. That is a huge document, and you can see
so
whole open source related
this
thing.
Particular link, egostandards.go.in.
We will have a look, but I think it's important that we start sharing all this. Because of course this is part of the lobby I was saying before.
Yeah.
You know, if someone says something and you can send them a list of 50 documents that are for ODF, it's going to be difficult to say that Office Open XML is the reference standard everywhere.
Yeah.
Yes, even for, I talked about fuel project, so that it become the standard for terminology and style guide, etc. Because it's open and it's open source and free, available under a different open source license. So there are, apart from Microsoft glossaries, there are a whole lot of glossaries there. Fuel project glossary become the style guide, become the standard glossary for the government of India.
Yeah.
Okay. So thanks.
Okay.
Thanks everybody.
I think that we have